morning and welcome. Thank you for tuning in to this latest edition of UNODC Conversations, a special series brought to you by the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime. As many of you know, UNODC Conversations features eminent public icons reflecting on some of the key challenges facing the region pertaining to health, justice and security. Joining us today in an exclusive interaction is the Ambassador of Japan to India, Mr. Kenji Hiramatsu. Excellency, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.
We are extremely honored to have you with us today.
I'm happy to be here.
I begin with asking you, Japan has been at the forefront of the global efforts against organized crime, drug use, human trafficking, and terrorism. As the Ambassador of Japan to India, please share your insights on the global and Asian challenges that threaten nations today.
I think the issue we are facing is becoming more multifaceted. We need our global solutions. That is the reason why organizations like UNODC is playing a very vital role. Issues are very complex. Living in this part of the world, we see various challenges we are facing, especially in terms of terrorism, about poverty eradication, diseases, and religious tensions, and all other things. Especially the issue of terrorism is getting more serious. The ISIS operation in Syria, Iraq has been diminishing, but foreign terrorist fighters are spreading around the world, and many bases are relocated in other parts of the world, including South Asia. So issues are serious. As you witnessed last year, July, the terrorist attack took place in Dhaka, and 7 Japanese nationals are killed. So we are very concerned about the situation. To tackle with the terrorism issue needs a more comprehensive approach, not only dealing with the terrorism per se, but to deal with more comprehensive issues like eradication of poverty, how to have a more harmonious community, how to have a more less religious tensions. So I think, as I said at the beginning, we need a more global solutions and global threats to these issues.
So, as you are aware, UNODC works on the core themes of health, justice, and security. For Japan, which are the important areas related to these themes? For possible or ongoing cooperation with South Asian countries? And are there any best practices from Japan which can be emulated in these countries? Because South Asia, as you know, is suffering from drug use, trafficking, and terrorism, and these related issues.
It is difficult to pick up one agenda because, as I said, all issues are interlinked. So we need a comprehensive approach. That's why UNODC's approach is very variable. Terrorism per se, but looking at the issue of heroes and others. So we need the 3 pillars of UNODC is very good approach. Basically we are helping, for example, border control and better law enforcement, especially by human resource development and technical assistance to the people deal with these issues. And we have especially supporting the program to support border control and community building, and also to establish a center for intelligence and information sharing in this region. That is one small attempt, but Japan is very serious in supporting UNODC, especially in their capacity building operation, which deals with a very different agenda, as you mentioned. 3 pillars of UNODC is very important.
From the Japanese standpoint, what are the key security challenges facing Asia today? And what are your views on nuclear terrorism and threats of war from certain countries in the region and the prevailing tensions between superpowers? How serious is the situation in your view?
It's difficult to say in 1 minute. There are so many different issues we have to deal with. The situation is now changing. Global strategic landscape is now shifting, so we have to deal with these issues in a very intelligent and collective manner. And also the issue of contact in York, and we have been having a series of nuclear terrorism summit meeting. So we are actively participating in these issues. And also, of course, the situation surrounding North Korea is very serious. The level of threat has entered a new stage. Again, we need a very uniform, united solution that all countries are united to pressurize North Korea to abandon nuclear arms and munitions. So again, we need a very global and united solution on these issues.
Cyber security is a growing global threat. Cyber threats are attacking and damaging businesses and governments across the world. How important is the issue of cyber security for Japan? And what are some of the steps that you are taking and are willing to support other countries with regard to cyber security?
Yes, cyber security is very serious, not only for Japan, but also for the entire world. Japan has established a kind of organization to deal with this cybersecurity issue from a very comprehensive manner, with the participation of many experts in this organization. So we are not only dealing with our internal cybersecurity issues, but we are participating in many discussions with regard to how to tackle these cybersecurity issues, especially how to have a more legal framework the cyber space. The United Nations have been discussing what kind of law will be applied in cyberspace. And also we are supporting other, especially developing countries, to have more capacity building in order that they are better prepared for a future cyber attack coming from other countries. And also we are having bilateral discussions with many countries to share information, to share knowledge, to tackle this collectively against the cyber attack. And with India also, we have recently had the discussion with cyber security experts from India.
So coming to the Sustainable Development Goals, how is Japan strengthening the global development agenda? And how do you see South Asia's progress in addressing SDGs? Are we on the right path?
Japan has been contributing to SDG for many years. We are a kind of a country who initiated initiative to start SDGs and follow up initiatives of this SDG. We have been participating in discussion from its past stage. So we are very serious, not only dealing with our SDG agenda in Japan, but also to support other countries to SDG goals, and especially have a special interest in global disease, global health issues, and also preparedness for natural disaster and terrorism issues. We extend a lot of support to the former ODA and through international organization like UNODC, and also the issue of health is among the main pillars for our assistance program to other countries. I hope the concept of universal healthcare will be shared by many countries. The progress for achieving SDGs is work in progress. Still many things need to be done, especially this area of the world. We are facing a lot of issues which may require the collective address by many countries taking into account ICDC goals. I'm sure that many countries in this region, including India, has incorporated SDG ideas in their own development policies, which is very welcome. So based on this very well-structured strategy and policy on the part of developing countries, Japan is very keen to support these countries in helping achieve this important goal of SDGs. SDGs is very holistic, it's a kind of approach. We like not tackling with these different goals in silo, but important thing is how to deal with in a comprehensive manner, how to tackle those issues in a very collective manner. So we are having a lot of strategic discussions with many countries. That is very important to identify the realities of these countries, and terrorism and drug always issue of great interest for Portugal.
So how do you see the relationship with India? India and Japan are embarking on a new partnership and stronger partnership. How do you see the relationship going on in the future?
I am very happy to say that our relationship between Japan and India is the best ever in the history. So we are embarking on various issues for mutual cooperation, including the issue of economic development. Japan is very happy to support India's endeavor to enhance the level of living standards and supporting the eradication of poverty and tackling with diseases and infectious diseases, and also how to have a better sanitation standards. So the agenda we are working together is very comprehensive and very wide ranging, but we are very committed to support India's endeavor to achieve various ambitious goals based on the SDG under the very strong leadership of Prime Minister.
Sir, Japan is a very valued partner for UNODC. How do you see the relationship between UNODC and the government of Japan evolving in the years to come? And please share any specific areas where you feel joint projects or cooperation can be initiated, especially for South Asia.
I have a personal affection to UNODC. As in my previous post as a Deputy Minister for Foreign Policy, I initiated strategic dialogue with Executive Director Mr. Bedotov, and we came up with an action plan for future. So we have already identified some of the priority areas for cooperation. So we think that based on that, we should reinforce our commitment to support UNODC. And UNODC is dealing with a very different and important comprehensive agenda. So we hope that we can be able to support this organization, especially traffic issues and cross-border terrorism issues, border control. And I hope my predecessors will continue to have this kind of strategic dialogue with Mr. Bedotov in order that we be better prepared for supporting important agenda, especially in this region. I hope more should be done with regard to border control. Traffic issue is becoming very serious, and we are always looking very carefully at possible terrorism activities in this region. But I hope that many Japanese colleagues will be able to work near UNODC. We have talented people eager to support this very noble cause that UNODC is advocating.
Thank you very much for your time, Excellency. It was truly a pleasure talking to you.
And
your insights were very valuable. And we look forward to your continued support to our efforts. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.